This is Today in Nashville, a celebration of the people, places, and things that make Music City a great place to live. Now your hosts, Kelly Sutton and Carole Sullivan.
Everybody, welcome to the show. We've got good stuff today.
Yes, we do. Nashville is going to be filled with even more music than ever this week. It's because Americana Fest starts today.
Yes, it does. Cheers to that. We love this time of year.
One of the featured bands, Treetop Flyers, is here. We're going to hear some of their folk rock music. Hello, hello. And we're going to let you know when you can see them live. They're from overseas.
We have such a now overseas contingency coming in.
International show.
We just had a band from Sweden that was amazing, and we fell in love with them, and now Treetop Flyers are here. I mean, it's just going to keep getting better. We're international, baby.
Yes, we are.
Yes, we are.
Going places.
I love that. All right, we've got all the details on Americana Fest. Executive producer of the event, Jed Hilly, is here. I was talking to him. I said, this is like your wedding week, Super Bowl, all rolled into one. He's going to tell us what's in store for the next 6 days and how you can take it all in.
What an amazing 6 days it'll be. We are enjoying a little bit of Centennial Chardonnay from our friends at City Winery.
Ooh.
But they're cooking an amazing dish. It is risotto like no other. We're using farro, which is great. Okay, so we've got their executive chef there. He's prepping the kale. This is a dish I am pumped about. City Winery doing half-price wine right now. Yeah. So they've got just such a cool vibe and
so
great deals. And this is the time of year where, in fall, they really shine. It's a good time.
I love it all. He is one of the top 1% Ironmen worldwide. Such an amazing story. Shay Eskew is here. This Williamson County dad just came back from the World Championship in South Africa. When we say just came back,
he just came back. So his new book is coming out. It's called What the Fire Ignited. This is all about how he overcame severe burns. He's a burn survivor from his childhood and was basically told, just forget it. You can't do anything athletic. And boy, did he show the world and is showing all of us as he's one of the top triathletes in the entire world. An amazing story to tell.
We're inspired.
I know.
And hearing the things that he's done in his life, it's just, it's almost
like
too
living
good
in the
to
woods,
be true.
Trapping bears?
Like trapping bears for 6 months. Because, yes,
why
he
not?
Lived in the woods. Trapping bears. So good. We can't wait to talk to Shay. And one of our favorites is here, Vance Nichols. You have outdone yourself, my friend. It is gorgeous. Vance is from Fontenelle. He's getting us prepped for fall. He's going to show us how to take our home decor to the next level. Beautiful flowers. Look at that planter box and the cute little decorations.
I'm telling you, listen, pre-Vance in my life, flowers just died in my house.
Right.
Vance enters my life, and now I buy flowers like once a week, and I arrange them.
See, I don't go that
far. He's changed my life.
I don't go that far, but I do feel like I could possibly try something.
Yeah, you're thinking about it.
I'm thinking about it.
Which is
baby steps.
Which is half the battle.
Yeah, it is baby steps.
Oh,
for me,
we're so glad you're with us.
Yeah.
And we need to take a moment. I mean, it is 9/11. Before even coming in here, I had to sit in my car just for a few moments. Kind of do this every year. I'm sure you probably have a moment yourself. It's kind of hard to believe. It's been 17 years since 9/11.
Years.
And I sort of take that time to have a moment to think back and
everything that happened, how it all changed just in the blink of an eye.
It's never been the same.
No.
Across the country, people pausing and remembering thousands that were lost on that day. Here's a look at some of the remembrance ceremonies at the World Trade Center site this morning. As tradition, the names of the victims being read.
And there were also 9/11 events back here at home. MTSU had a ceremony at the Veterans Memorial on campus. Nashville Mayor David Briley, he honored first responders in a special event as well. And then today at 4, Fort Campbell is going to host a wreath-laying ceremony. That's happening at the division headquarters. It is open to the public, so if you'd like to be a part of that, that's happening there. And of course, our thoughts and prayers are still with all of the families. 17 years later, they're still dealing with the aftermath of what happened. And I mean, as a country, I don't know that we'll ever get over that, but we certainly need to remember all of those who are part of it, and especially the first responders.
For sure.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Okay, so celebration is happening here.
Tell me about last night. That's all I want to know as we move ahead.
Luke Bryan
concert.
Let me tell you. LB, you did good.
Does he go by LB?
Sometimes.
This is new to me. Well, did you just make that up?
That's what I call him. Luke. I love Luke. Another successful show in the books. This one was Free. It was on Broadway.
Now that's a concert Thrifty Carole likes.
Listen.
Broadway was filled. People were loving it.
You got your hands up. You're rocking in my truck. You got the radio on.
I love it. Yep. All part of the grand opening celebration for his new bar and restaurant, Luke 32 Bridge. 75 minutes playing in the streets. Wow,
look at
this. I love
these.
It doesn't get old. I love looking at these pictures. Love seeing Broadway so alive and having that outdoor concert there.
30,000 people. That's Ryan Hurd. Ryan Hurd is his own artist in his own right, has amazing, amazing songs and a great catalog. But Ryan wrote Sunrise, Sunburn, Sunset for Luke Bryan. That went number one yesterday.
Oh, how great.
So he opened a new bar. He played to 30,000 plus people on Broadway, and he had the number one song in country music
yesterday. Just another day in the life of LB.
Just another day.
As I'm now calling him.
You should totally call him that. But yeah, Luke's 32 Bridge is now open.
Six floors. You said Six floors.
There's a peanut gallery.
Are the floors 5 feet high?
Basement.
Is that how they squeeze that many in?
So massive.
I didn't think that building was that high.
It is massive.
Wow.
Huge. And it's really cool because there's something different on each one of the floors. There's a sushi bar on the roof. I mean, yeah. Just go check it out. It's a good time.
I love it.
It's a real good time.
Okay, so this made me pretty happy last night. I know it made you happy. Yes, Kelsey Ballerini joining The Voice because The Voice loves Nashville.
Yes. Okay.
So now Kelsey is going to be a new judge on the show.
Okay.
Love it.
This is really cool. Something different. This is the comeback stage.
It's a new
stage.
Twist.
New stage. This is a new stage, a new twist. So the people that don't get a chair to turn in the blind auditions, they will be coached by Kelsey for the comeback stage. She's gonna help them. And then at one point during the season, they'll have a chance to come back and be a part of the competition.
Hence the comeback.
Right.
I love it.
Brilliant.
I love the underdog. So
it's
that'll
so
be
good.
Fun to watch.
And
so
just,
that's
I
like an
her.
Online component that
yeah.
they are doing with the show. And then of course they'll bring it all together.
So nice. Glad for her.
That's
a good time.
I just realized I have my hairband on.
This is
my
me
wrist.
24/7. I usually have it on.
This one's a little.
That's not too bad.
Out.
At least it's black. Mine's usually like pink stripes or totally. Something ridiculous. Anyway, this could be the best flight ever. Check it out.
Now, this doesn't happen when my plane's ever diverted or there's a problem, but this one turned into a pizza party for so many. How about that? They were supposed to fly from LA to Dallas. The flight got diverted because there were some problems with weather. Went to Wichita Falls, and they were like, well, now what? Well, the pilot on American Airlines went above and beyond, ordered pizza for all the passengers, all 159.
And
I don't know what's happening right here.
He delivered. He personally delivered the food to everybody.
Oh, that was the delivery car.
Yeah.
I got you.
So he goes, he gets them, and he goes over, and he's like,
that's
pizza?
So nice.
I mean, well done. If he doesn't get a raise out of that, maybe his contract was up, and he's like, watch
yeah,
this.
Yeah, here we go.
Watch this. I love it. Okay, in the form of a question.
Yes, I'm ready.
Which TV show host shocked the world with his new look?
Oh, shocked the world. You know, only one person could do that.
Alex
Trebek.
Yeah,
sporting
Trebek.
Sporting the beard.
What?
Ooh, what team are we on here, Kel? So,
yes. He looks so different.
New season. Beard or he came out with the beard.
Beard or no beard?
I don't know. He looks younger without the beard.
Oh, he does look younger without the beard. But he looks like he's more fun with the beard. Maybe because he's smiling.
No,
I don't know.
I'm no beard. You know.
All right. Here's
I know Nashville's
Facebook.
Very pro facial hair, but sometimes
I kind of dig it.
Looks a little warm.
I kind of dig it. I like the warm. You know, he looks a little Grizzly Adams with that, and I'm feeling it.
Gosh,
I don't
Grizzly
know.
Adams.
It's good.
So on Facebook,
yeah.
The majority liked beard.
I like Facebook.
Well,
facial
I'm going
hair.
Against the grain and
that's
saying.
That's fine. Okay, quick.
Turn it up.
Does Mike
yes.
have a beard?
No.
Paul does. There it is.
Oh,
that's why.
Oh, there you go. But when I was in the throes of courtship with my husband, he grew this. Maybe this was a test. He grew this.
Oh, the goatee?
But then he would twist it.
Oh,
he came to
no.
a point. It was,
and you still got married?
It was just this thing.
Gosh, no. What was he?
But
Shaggy
it was during
from Scooby-Doo?
Season, so maybe it was some sort of thing.
Oh,
you know what?
That's
I haven't
a
asked him about
fail.
This.
That is
I have to ask him about
friends,
it.
Friends, if you're watching
he
and
was,
you've got that, go cut it right
no,
now.
He looked
that's
good.
A fail.
He looked good.
With the twist.
Yeah, you know what? He's a He's a good looking man.
I can't. Like, all. All right. Big congratulations to our friends Drew and Ellie Holcomb.
So many reasons to cheers
incredible
today.
Incredible humans, incredible musicians, and now they have a new bundle of joy.
Oh, look at this sweet family. Their third child. I love it. Drew posted this on social media. Welcome to the world, Samuel Rivers Holcomb. We're glad you're here.
Get this. Ellie and Drew performed this past weekend at the Moon River Festival in Chattanooga.
That is not her.
That's
days
her.
Before the baby.
That's her. Look
what?
At her arm muscles.
Gosh,
look at her. Looking
amazing.
Gorgeous. And then she delivered her baby. That was Saturday. She delivered the baby on Monday. Wonder Woman. Ellie Holcomb.
You know what?
Hats off.
She's so beautiful
so
inside.
Gorgeous. Yeah.
It just like, blah.
It's like
streams of sunshine
oozes.
Shoot out of her.
Just my oozes hair just from her.
Blind.
Oozes
I'm
all
a disaster
over.
Disaster today.
Did you just put hair in my wine?
I think my hair is in your wine. Sorry, Kill. Protein.